Hello everyone, today we do experiment one, which is the Brewster angle. According to Brewster law, the incoming light partially polarized when reflected off an unconductive surface. And we do this experiment today. As you see, the incoming light comes to the non-conductive surface, it will be reflected and also it will be refracted. The reflected part has a polarized light, and we can find the angle, Brewster angle, from this formula. And in the experiment, we draw ratio versus angle graph, and it looks like this. And its minimum will be given with this formula, and we can find the Brewster angle with this formula. Here, ratio is the ratio is given by total light, which is the total light is the reflected light, as a divided by polarized light. We measure these two parts and we obtain the ratio, and we draw ratio as a function of angle in this experiment. We have different components in the experiment, which is one of these is the laser, the other is the polarizer. We have slit here. We have a light sensor at the end of the setup, and we have a D-shape lens. We find the refraction index of this lens. We change the angle with the help of this light sensor, like this. When I push the start button, we have two different windows. The first window is the angle, and the other window is the light intensity, and we have a table here. The first row of this table, or the first column of this table, is the angle, and the second column is the total light, and the third column is the polarized light, and the ratio automatically filled in the last column. And as you see, in this alignment, we read the total light. And if we put this transmission window, we can write the polarized light in the third column. We can start with the angle. We measure the total light and the polarized light at this angle. As you see, the angle is here, automatically filled, and the light intensity is here, but we can adjust. Okay, we have different types of windows here. The first one is the angle, which gives us the position of the light sensor. The second one is the light intensity, is the incoming light intensity, can be read from this window. We have a table. First column is the angle. Second column is the total light. Third column is the polarized light. I put a transmission window in front of the light sensor to read this polarized part. And ratio will be automatically filled. And when I change the position of the light sensor, and I put D lens at the center, which we will try to find the refraction index of this lens. And the total light is given here, and I write the value of total light intensity to this row. And to find polarized light, I put transmission window in front of the sensor, and the light intensity decreased zero, but I can read this by changing the intensity multiplier of the light sensor. And when I press the keep button, the second column or second row will appear, and I change the position of the light sensor. Okay, we find the data table here. We change some data with changing the positions of the light sensor, and we corrected the table. And as you see, the angle, total light, polarized light, and ratio table here. As you see, the graph will looks like this, and the x-axis is the angle, the y-axis is the ratio, which gives us a quadratic polynom, the second order polynom. A theta square plus b theta plus g is our function, and if we take derivative of this function with respect to theta, and then we can find the minimum value of the angle, which is the Brewster angle. As you see, it's about the 60 degree, and you can find the theta values, and then you can find the refractive index of the D lens.